I'm going to talk a little bit about the Alan Watts. Oh my God, goodness, again. Oh yes, I've been listening. I think I went through 47 of them in a row of those particular here-tos. And oh my goodness. Well, back to this talk of the existentialism experience. Now, if he is the same one that is from the Berkeley that has the long-haired dreads, then perhaps I do remember him from when I was a child, growing there in that particular area. So if he is the same person, and then that is interesting also, because now I do remember the cup. I remember the cup explicitly from that person. That person had a cup there, and it was chewed at. Over the time frame of the duration of this cup, it became more and more chewed at, and so it was like, well, my goodness, he's not getting a replacement for it, that is obvious, and he is not really a movable object of person. He is not movable. He is just there. He is just a person who stays there, often because his hair is heavy. His hair is extremely heavy. And there were many characters like this in that region that went heavy hair. No, they're not movable. You can't just pick them up and move them around easy. So it is possible he was there. I'm not sure. It could have been another. But however, it is interesting remembering to that region in a lot of the guru, what do we call them, the guru yogis, yogi style. I'm practicing my yogi here, and for many days here on the, oh my gosh, I wrecked the tempura and start, and I went wrong with the wing. And so now I have to make, I've repaired it, and I'm putting flowers there. So I have updated it quite a bit. But I'm learning from this experience. Start in the center of your temporas. Start in the center, and then bloom out. Otherwise, you end up scratching the others. So yeah, don't want to. Oh my gosh, it takes time and energy. This, but yeah, back to the cup. Oh my gosh, that was a distress for me, because the cup at some point, it cannot be filled. It cannot be filled with enough coins. They will fall out. So these types of issues start to become a compilant in my mind when I'm a small young child. These cups, if it is the only one with a cup, or there was another one with a cup, I'm not sure or certain. But however, that enemy there of it degrading the degradation process right there in the eyes of the persons of the seemingly who have. So it's an odd woe out, like, what happens, you know, why have such the difference, we'll say it, and it is always that in the mind it is that slap in the face, you know, like, oh my gosh, you know, you cannot ever be rich, you cannot really ever be rich, because in the rich, in the wealth, in the greed, in all of this way, because you have seen him, don't you understand? You cannot be that way, because you have seen him. He brings your compassion state back in, he draws your compassion state back in, to go, oh my gosh, I can never be the greedy rich, I will always be something else. So for the hardship of those persons out there who do what do they call them, the yogi style, they are the wakers of the overdones, and they wake them up. They wake them up, and they turn their heads around in a circle a few times, so they are the volunteers, and they are the charitables, and they are the donators of many things. So there is a journey there also, even in that wild interchange of woe, you know, it's a woe moment. So yeah, and in the quiet. Okay, so we'll go back to into the existentialism of that experience, that is an existential moment, you know, where you are so apart from everyone else, and they are in the swirl of their lives going through. But you cannot say that he is the only one in the existential moment. You cannot see that the person there, the yogi on the street, the Buddhist there, you cannot say that he is the only existential one in the experience. It does realm it quite heavy to go, oh my gosh, he is definitely the most proven looking existentialist at that moment. But in all truth and reality, I don't know. He could perhaps go home and maybe lives in the house and is very talkative and has quite a social life other. And existentialism is often put into that data bank, that it is an abstinence of others, it is the solitary experience, and all kinds of things, seclusions and reclusions, and just put yourself away from the entire world type of experience. That's really what is thought of. And so when you're thinking of the yogi on the street, as existential as he seems in that oh my gosh, it's an abrupt from the others. He is very much in a social environment, very much so, and very much so a social environment, just by being a watcher of them, and so. We are now here talking of the internet. Now the internet is another social environment. It just keeps trying to say there are circles and there are these hangouts, and then there's over here you can go and watch this person, and then you can watch that one, and then you can write and type to them. And these are all social moments. We can have social events, and these are communication. And so existentialism is like, oh my gosh, I'm not sure I'm existentialist. And I'm not sure if that would be communication that I allow. However, of course, you can be existentialist. You can be in a ballet company and dance with many persons, and yet be existentialist. You don't have to be the chatter outer, because once you become this chatter outer type, you do feel like, oh my gosh, I really have parted with my existentialism. And perhaps it is not something you want to keep with you forever and ever and ever. A true existentialist, I guess you could say they are those ones from the meteora of the gracious land up there, living on the house that is on the pinnacles of the stones. Perhaps that is a true existentialist. However, he's given the dogma of Christianity, so. If he's giving the dogma of Christianity up there, you know, fed through with a basket. So there he is. And he is truly those types, the monks that are given the out. They are definitely the most existentialist proven. However, if they are still going by the same ridiculia documentation from before, I am not sure how that is anything but a pyration of glory back to Christianity. So it's not really a true existential self, is it? Because it is one that is adopting religion, is one that is adopting one that is already given to you. A true existentialistic experience is one where you go into yourself, and you start making the findings on your own. You can grab carry from other personal experiences in the life. However, these are still mementos that are coming out of you. These are still your own momentums coming out of you. This is your own experience that is a hollerant of person that it is. And so now I've seen this other person's, and they have equated it with an abstinence of alcohol. And there's nothing to do with abstinence of alcohol. I'm not sure how that happened, but because of the social beast is mixed in with the drinks, it has become a conclusion with existentialism equals alcohol, or equals going away from alcohol. And this one is incorrect. This is absolutely kind of, it just went down the wrong way. No, that's just not being around alcohol. You can be with those persons. You can actually be at those persons' situations. However, it is not necessarily something you are in an enjoyment with, and they may not be in enjoyment with you either, because you are most likely a quieter type, rather than most likely a quieter type. So I'm not saying the talking, I'm not saying communication here on the internet, I'm not saying any of these things apart you from existentialism. It's definitely a meditative inner conclusion self. You do come to many conclusions, and some of them are drastic and some of them are not drastic. And yet you do find a more powerful state. I found much of a more powerful self, and yet I'm not necessarily happy with it. Not necessarily happy with such a demand on the powerful self that has arisen. I don't really like it, you know, because it is sadly equated with an older woman with perhaps a testosterone higher in inner hormones, you know. And so I'm like, no, I'm not really wanting that equation. That wasn't really the goal of existentialism. That wasn't really existentialism, not existentialism. That's like extending on the credit card. I'm sorry, the existentialism. Yeah, make sure, yeah. You don't want the other one. Oh my gosh. Oh, so anyway, yeah, I don't know. Oh, so that's all. And so when they're going off their alcohol and they say, I don't want to see the friends anymore, I don't want to talk to the friends anymore, they're not my people, I don't want to deal with them, I don't want to chill out with them, I don't want to deal with any of that, that's different. That's just a change of yourself. It is a step in the direction of existentialism, true. It is a step there. It is another step into being further and further parted from the others. And when I say being parted from the others, that means being parted from their thoughts, being parted from their ways of repetition, their ways of their momentum at you. That's the parting from. That's what you have to get. It's not just here as a drink and parting from that. That is only one thing. It is many, 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 many things that you have to face. And so it's only the beginning. It's only the beginning. If you really are going to say, it is for me the start, not going to a AAA meeting or something, this is the difference. So, yeah, I know it's a... It's another type, yeah, they have those other types. I believe also you do need a quiet situation. And I'm thinking, well, quiet situation is just here every day at this computer, isn't it? A quiet situation. Many of us are here with our existentialism. And you can say, well, it's a shared existentialism then. We're having a shared existentialism experience with the computer. And then there's emails, and then there are forums, and then there are the rights that you write, and then the bickerings back and forth. And I'm like, oh, wait a minute, that's them again. And so that is the bringing in, isn't it? It's the bringing in of all of that again. And so it's just a rewrite, and you have learned nothing. You have not learned one thing at all. And it just becomes like, oh my gosh, I got to grab at it. I got to grab at that's sociality, a sociality contract. I have to re-grab at it. That is, oh my gosh, I need it. And so how do you learn out of it? You know, how do you learn out of it and even begin to grasp philosophy? Because with philosophy itself is as a place that is so far that it does enter into psychology, unfortunately. Philosophy itself does query reality, and when you are querying reality and its objectives and its goals, oh my gosh, resentment of authority does start to swirl back at them. You know, you start to have this resentment at the authorities from before, because they have put such walls so high that they are like there again and again and again. And so they have to be just forgotten. They have to be forgotten. Those walls from the person's the rights and those rules from before, they have to be forgotten. And you're like, well, how do you make changes for the world? Everyone's in this demand for it. You know, we have to make changes now. Well, dissipate the walls. Make those walls go away, you know, those persons and their hold on that expectation of others. And so it's like, how do you crumble their particular their facades, their well, it's giving them credence, isn't it? It's giving them credence again and again and again and again. Why are we giving them the credence? Why are they getting the credence of And unfortunate, with every telephone bill that arrives, every electric bill, anything from society from this direction is a re-stipulation of that wall, and so I don't really know how to get out of it completely, because that wall is the utility companies also inclusion. The utility companies have stopped my philosophy process from gaining any further, and I'm feeling kind of objectified by them, and I'm not really sure what to do about it. I can cast it all away. I can turn it all off. I can say I don't want it anymore. But I've done this already. I've lived with the wood stove by myself. It is not an enjoyable experience. It's very difficult to eat properly. Very difficult to eat. I'm not prepared for that environment, and to be completely without the talk to machine here is the same as talking to a tape recorder, isn't it? It is the same as talking to yourself in the mirror. It is the same as, you know, you have these same as going on. I'm like, oh, somebody wants to regard and say a word of verbatim back to me. What is this? You know, it's just their pluck out I'm with you, or no, I'm not with you, and it just becomes this or that, yes or no, yes or no, yes or no, and it's just like I don't need the comments rolling. No, that's not necessary either. It really does become an existentialism machine here, and I have become so in tune with it being this way that yes, you we are in distressance of who is even on the right. You know, who is even on the right. Who is on the right of, what have I got here? Oh my gosh, I know, I'm in the midst of repairs of my sweater. Yeah, even on the right. So, with existentialisms, it is not supposed to be necessarily hardship. We're not supposed to be the hardship gatherers, you know, But unfortunately, the utility company is a recreation that is just a throw-through, isn't it? A throw-through again, that you are not alone. You're not alone in this world. It is their regimen of of work through. And so I'm like, oh my gosh, all right. So I want to be existentialism so much so that I'm there and I make this stupid perpetual wheel thing. I am existentialist so much so that, yeah, that would be completely off-grid and I would never ever have to even look at one of these authoritarian complex wall builders again. I would never, ever have to receive it in the mail. So that is a goal. That is a goal for anybody who's looking for perpetual or alternative energy means. Absolutely. That is a true freedom. That is your true freedom away, and then you can start. Then you can start with your philosophies. Philosophy is just like get real. You know, how can I even get deeper into this sucker? I can't. I'm getting the bills in the mail.